Hello friends, you are again welcome in government job and preparation. So we have done 45 questions in last two videos. अगर आपने अभी तक नहीं देखा है तो please check it. Channel को subscribe भी कर लीजिए and please watch the video complete. So starting with 46 question number. Which of the following condition has increased risk of hyperkalemia? Hyperkalemia is increased potassium level in blood. तो ये condition किसकी वजह से हो सकती है? You have the options. So option number 4. End stage renal disease. Option number 4. End stage renal disease. Kidney failure impair potassium excretion and risk of hyperkalemia. Next, during resuscitation in an infant, ratio of chest compression and ventilation should be. Infant में chest compression और ventilation का ratio कितना होना चाहिए? So answer is 3:1. Option number C. In infant, the recommended compression ventilation ratio is 3:1. 3 compression, 1 ventilation. Next, inclined with C4. C4 is cervical. Cervical 4 spinal cord injury is greater risk 4. इस वाले condition में क्या-क्या risk हो सकता है? So, option में है आपका, जो right option है, that is respiratory compromise. We have read in last videos कि अगर cervical में कोई injury होता है, and this is a C4, तो all the 4 limbs plus respiratory compromise भी हो जाता है. This is very risky. Respiratory compromise, high cervical injury, C3 to C5. अगर C3 से C5 में injury है, तो it can cause respiratory compromise. क्यों? Because it affect diaphragm inversion. And this is risk for respiratory failure. Next, the microorganism usually part of normal vaginal flora but can cause meningitis in newborn. What is this organisms? So this is option number 3. Group B, streptococci. This is the part of normal vaginal flora but it can cause meningitis in newborn. GBS bhi bolte hai isko short form mein. GBS colonize vagina transmission during delivery may cause neonatal meningitis. Next, a pregnant woman diagnosed with severe anemia, anemia is less than 7, should be treated with. Pregnant woman hai, 7 HB hai, aur this is the condition of severe anemia. Is condition mein aap iska treatment kya karenge? So, right is option number 3. Packed cell transfusion, PC. टी करेंगे आप इसका. इन सीवियर एनीमिया रैपिड करेक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड, पैक्ड आरबीसी ट्रांसफ्यूजन इज प्रेफर्ड. बाकी सारे तो धीरे-धीरे करेंगे. ऑप्शंस हमारा जो 3 ऑप्शन है दैट विल मैसिवली एक्यूट इंक्रीज इन ब्लड दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन प्रेग्नेंट वुमन. Next is, all are the clinical feature of meningitis except. Meningitis ka feature jo nahi hai, wo aapko batana hai. So this is option number 4, constipation. Constipation is not the feature of meningitis. Classic feature of meningitis are fever, irritability and poor feeding. High pitched cry, seizure and neutral rigidity. Constipation is not typical. Next, what should be the immediate action in severe bleeding? Severe bleeding hai to kya karna chahiye? Immediate action, apply pressure to the wound. Direct pressure is the most effective first aid step to control hemorrhage until definitive care. Next, adrenaline dose in anaphylactic shock is. Anaphylactic shock hai, to adrenaline ka dose kitna hota hai? So right is option number A, 1:1,000, 0.5 ml, 1:1,000. Adrenaline 0.5 ml of 1:1000 IM is the drug for choice in anaphylaxis. Next, how many moments of hand hygiene are laid down by WHO? Kitna hand hygiene, movement of hand hygiene pucha hai. So, movement aapko karna hai, ye bahut confusing hai. Steps of hand hygiene and movement of hand hygiene. Movement matlab kab kab ki situation mein aapko karna hi karna hai. So, both are different things, confused nahi hona hai. Jyada tar practical viva mein bhi confused ho jate hai. So, answer is 5. WHO recommended 5 movement of hand hygiene. What? Before touching the patient, before clean aseptic procedure, after exposure to the body fluid, after touching patient, and after touching surrounding. These are the 5 hand hygiene moment. इसमें भी आपसे पूछ सकते हैं, कुछ भी दे देंगे option में और कुछ नहीं देंगे और accept भी पूछ सकते हैं. तो this is important. Before touching the patient, before doing any asepsis or clean procedure, after exposure the body fluid, after touching the patient and after touching patient surrounding. Surrounding means agar bed ko, IV stand ko, kisi ko bhi touch kiya hai, linen ko, to you have to go for the hand washing. Next, long standing high blood pressure may result in. क्या क्या complication हो सकता है अगर long time तक high blood pressure रहता है तो? Option number 4. Cardiomegaly, cardiac failure and heart attack. Chronic hypertension can cause hypertrophy, cardiomegaly, heart failure and increased risk of myocardial infarction. Next, drug of choice for convulsion in eclampsia. Eclampsia में drug of choice convulsion को prevent करने के लिए. So that is option number 3, magnesium sulfate. Magnesium sulfate is the gold standard anti-convulsant in eclampsia management. Next, a client with psychotic depression receiving haloperidol, this is antipsychotic drug, may develop which side effect? Kaun sa side effect kar sakti hai? Akathisia, that is cause akathisia. Haloperidol is a typical antipsychotic that may cause extrapyramidal side effect, EPS jisko bolte hai, including akathisia, means restlessness. Patient hamesha restlessness rehta hai. Next, immediate management to restore BP and circulation in a client with multiple fracture and fluid loss is. Agar koi multiple condition ki wajah se multiple fracture ho gaya, fluid loss ho gaya, to immediate management kya karenge to restore BP and circulation. So right answer is RL infusion. Ringer lactate is the body fluid of choice for resuscitation in trauma with hypovolemia. Next, which hormone is also known as emergency hormone? So that is option number 4, adrenaline. Adrenaline, that is called epinephrine also. It is the secreted by adrenal medulla during stress called the emergency hormone. Next, a lung disease caused by inhalation of cotton fiber dust. Cotton fiber dust ka inhale karne se, long term inhale karne se kaun si disease ho sakta hai? So that can cause biosinosis. Option number 2, biosinosis. Biosinosis is a brown lung disease bhi bolte hain, occur due to long term inhalation of cotton fiber in textile workers. Next question is, height measurement of a 2-year child is done by. 2 saal ke bacche ki height measurement kaise karenge? So option number 1, stadiometer. Stadiometer after age of 2 year height is measured in standing position using a stadiometer. Next, nurse notice clumpy precipitate in the NPH insulin vial. What should be the done? Agar NPH ki vial mein clumpy precipitate aapko dikh raha hai, toh what as a nurse you will do? So option number 3. Draw dose from a new vial. Nayi vial use karna hai aapko. Precipitate means contamination or expiry. Insulin should be discarded and use a new vial. Next, dimpa. Depo provera, it is an injectable contraceptive given every. Dimpa jo injection hai, wo kitne mahine mein diya jata hai. So right option is 3 months, every 3 months. Depot medroxy progesterone, is Dimpa ka full form hai. Depot medroxy progesterone acetate injection is given every 3 months for contraception. Next, nurse in PQ must give 400 ml of fluid in 8 hours. Draw factor is 60 GTT per minute. Flow rate kya hoga? Time 8 hours and draw factor diya hai. To fluid 400, time 8 hours hai. Isko humne minute mein convert kar liya. 480 minutes. Draw factor is this. So, ab hum volume nikalenge. Volume is 400 divided by 480. 400 volume and 480 minutes. So, humara agya 0.833 ml per minute. And this is multiplied by draw factor. So, my answer agya 50 drop per minute. Flow rate should be 50 drops per minute. 50 GTT per minute. Right answer is 50 drop per minute. 400 ml solve kiya to hamara aaya 50 drop per minute. Lekin isme 17 drop per minute kyu diya hai? Because it's for a micro drip. Calculated for micro drip factor. 60 GTT jo hota hai wo micro drip ke liye use hota hai. 60 wala. So it's calculated for micro drip. Agar sirf drop ka baat karein to that will be 50 drop per minute. Next, cardiac sign for cardiac arrest include all except. Cardiac arrest ke liye cardinal sign kya hote hain, except pucha hai kya nahi hota according to option. So right answer is dilated non-reactive pupil. Dilated non-reactive pupil. Cardiac arrest sign are absence of breathing, pulse and unresponsiveness. Pupil change occur later. Next है, which of the following is a mydriatic? Mydriatic जो pupil को dilate कर देते हैं, mydriatic बोलते हैं उनको, तो option में कौन सा है वो drug? So that is atropine. Atropine dilate pupil mydriasis भी बोलते हैं इसको, and it used in ophthalmology examination. Ophthalma अगर check आँखों को चेक करवाना है तो पहले उनको प्यूपिल डायलेट करते हैं और जो ड्रॉप्स यूज की जाती हैं दैट इज माइड्राइटिक. सो फ्रेंड्स आज के वीडियो में सिर्फ इतना ही. इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो विल जस्ट फिनिश इट. 80 क्वेश्चन है. सो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब शेयर एंड लाइक द चैनल लाइक द वीडियो. थैंक यू.